Hey, this is bad.
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these birds on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
He got dressed quick. Well, it showed
you
in his
made
garage.
Enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me.
Alright. Is this full frontal nudity? Close enough. I'll take it. Yeah, there's Playboy magazines you can pick up. Just like, I think, 37 of them. Vintage? Oh, hang on. Joe, let me see something about in here. Where's the shower? Usually, like, he says, like, oh, there's plenty of hot water.
Go ahead, there's plenty of hot water.
Yep, there it is. Alright, let's go, Joe. To the garage. This game is so fun. Here we go. Garage. It's on the second floor, surprisingly.
So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
I mean...
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful.
It is an all-terrain vehicle.
All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe. I know.
Woohoo, driving. Now, driving this game is exactly what I probably think.
Then just go straight for a while.
Yeah, when the roads are icy, you'll do that. I cleaned off that guy's windshield, though. These cars handle exactly what I probably think cars in the 1940s handle in the snow.
Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love it.
Barely been a minute.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
I mean, what am I gonna do? There's also a speed limiter you see there. I won't go anywhere above 40 miles an hour with it on.
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Oh, they also taught me how to shoot. You also have to get gas from gas stations and such. Just anything you think typical about a car. You have to get it repaired, loaded up with gas. Speed limiter, that way you don't get a ticket when you get pulled over.
Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.
Oh, okay. Giuseppe is the man to go to.
Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it.
He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off.
Perfect.
Hey, Giuseppe, I brought you a new customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retire,
Bay.
Please. How are you? The papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
I'll take that.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Me? $7 for a set of lockpicks. A must-have for breaking and entering. Will do.
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
Okay. Let's test drive this here. Move L to move the pin. When it's green, press square. Like that. Like that. Bingo.
See you around, Giuseppe. Say Benedict.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry. You'll get the hang of it.
Ciao.
I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
It's a nice skill to have. Which means we're going to steal this dude's car out back here.
Okay. You still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Let's go for it.
Well, here's your chance.
Yeah, hold to pick the lock. Else you won't even get in. It's only three. There we go. There we go. There we go. Easy peasy.
Possible stolen vehicle.
How does he already know?
Step on it.
Police want to arrest you.
Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
It's not over yet. Lose him, quick.
Vehicle is wanted by the police, which means they will know when the car is wanted. So I have to change the license plates, which they'll go over here soon. As soon as I get rid of this guy. But no, about the speed limiter thing. That's what will keep you from getting a speeding ticket. Sorry, old man. Woman.
All right. Looks like we lost him. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered.
I caught
that
close.
Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
Sweet.
Here, park right here in front of the garage door.
And honk before that cop sees me. Oh man, that was barely anything we messed up this car.
I can do for you?
Change plates, change the license plates, or repaint the car to legalize the car. Joe is paying this time. So let us change the plates.
For you,
change
no problem.
It. So, I think I know what I want, so... Let's do the typical. Okay, I was expecting this not to go through the numerals. There we go. There we go. Hey!
There you go. Give her a couple of...
You can tune the engine of the car to improve its performance. Joe is paying for you this time. Sweet. Car must be repaired, so repair it. Good as new. So let us tune it. Which means it'll drive a lot faster. Repaint
it. Paint it any color you like. Take your pick.
Don't mind if I do. I like this red. So let's go with that's a nice red. Burgundy. I think it's the only one, yeah. Sweet.
Got it. I'll get right on it.
Change the rims.
Looking for a new set of wheels?
Yes.
Take your pick, pal. But as of today,
Londoners are singing yes, sir. God, we love those Spitfires. Maybe the more yeah, I think we're good.
Thanks a lot.
We're good. Look at this beauty now. one that produced fuel. I like 40s and 50s cars. After several weeks of merciless punishment by this
long-range menace. All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
All right, let's go to Mike Bruski, the Bruskinator.
Who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters.
Hang on one second. I'll be right back with you. Okay, sorry about that.
Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants.
Nice.
Now here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
That's adorable.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Hey, man, don't knock until you try it.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
You're just now hearing this from him, dude, and he's your best friend?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You be the door and I'll slam you.
That was bad.
That was amazing.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
Well then. That was a little bit too much information there, Joe. But, no, the speed limiter.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.
Yeah, the speed limiter is exactly what it sounds like. It keeps you from getting a speeding ticket, because cops will pull your ass over if you're going too fast. And yes, you will have to pay the ticket if you get, if you slow down or, you know, like, put your car out for wanted. So hang on one second again.
Hey, look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
These guys are friends.
What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
And shook it anyways.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
And he knows
God
Jesus very well.
Mike, you put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs
Jesus
these days
Christ.
Plenty. And who knows if they can even get this filth
out. You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen.
Friends
up.
For life.
This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh? Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out.
Literally.
Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
Test it out? I just got back from the army. I should know how to fire. What, shoot the tires. Okay, so... Boop.
Boop. Hey, you ain't a bad shot. Hey, Vito, see if you can hit the gas tank.
All right. San Andreas? San Andreas?
Shit. Did I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Pollock joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.